Alright, this evening I'm going to talk a little about some art from the past, as I'm here back at the parental. So I'm thinking, well, it's an opportunity for bring up, like, what were they doing and why? And is there any relevance to it now, today, in this forma? This one in particular is material. This is material. On the frame with those, you get them at the Walmart, whatever. They're like these big glass bubbles. And I put them all the way around. It's kind of cute, actually, on the wall. You see that? It has the bubbles as the frame sequence. Yeah, so it goes, and it goes, and it goes. And yet, in the middle, in the center of it, it's a big lizard. Mr. Big Lizard is there. But yeah, it's one of... Actually, I really like it. I think it's one of my greatest, newest inventions of art. And I just stapled it on the back. So anybody could make these. You take material you like and you staple them on there. And then you pluck it on the wall. They're kind of heavy. Because of the bubbles, but it's fun. But yeah, so I got the what do you call this lizard? He's that particular lizard is an iguana. He is an iguana. There's many geckos there also. So yeah, you take a good, really good, interesting, it's a cheap piece of material also. You get that also from the Walmart. So reminiscing, like, well, this really got great, any of this. So now these ones are kind of vulgar. These ones, I made these in El Paso a long time ago. You see these big flowers, the fleur. They're vulgar because they're so open. They're so open and displayed, like, they're like drums, actually. They remind me of drums, like, what do we call them, the quinta, and the newest one I'm playing, we have the quinta, and the next one we have the tumba, is the big one. There's another one next to it, the conga. So the quinta, conga, and then tumba. Well, these ones are just the quinta and the tumba. No, sorry, the quinta and the conga. But the interesting that I painted them, because they are like this huge. You know what I'm saying? They're that big when you play them. So in their vulgarities, they are that big when you play them. But I don't know. It's interesting. This is my first attempt at watercolor, and I am a Turner, the Turner bloodline. And he was a famous watercolorist. So I think it's an interesting fascination to begin for me. But I think I'm a kind of a vulgarist. So my little congas here, it's more the conga event. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I think you understand. You understand. So why I chose a size flower, just a comfortability. The comfortability. And so as a player, as a musician also, these are comfortable sizes of drums for me. So there. So I guess it has that value. But I'm not happy. I'm not happy that I had them in such an exposure. So I'm going to hide them now. They're like, what do you call it? It's just my child art. It's just my child art that I made when I was, like, beyond a child. But yeah, they are my child art inferences. Because, my gosh, I just don't like it. I don't like it being that open. All right, so anyhow... I have also, in the update of today,
I have made an artist studio out in the back grounds of this habitation. It's a small little artist studio, and eventually one day I'll put an extra canopy on top for the rain. But it's I don't know, I guess you could be jealous of it because it is a big space around and around. So I now have my own little private art studio outside, and yet with a hut in the ceiling, and the wall enclosures yet open, and so I can paint now. Yeah, so it's a little con-tiki with bamboo and a giant bamboo. I'm using a little bit. Luckily, there's a giant bamboo con-tiki for the roofing, and then the other bamboos, and then what do you call those? They're kind of those walls that. The screens, yeah. So I'll try to get it on the computer tomorrow and show you exactly, because it's kind of fun. And the birds loved it. The birds are all happy. As soon as I was finished, they ran out all over the place, and they flew in, and they just started chirping on all the trees. They're just extra happy about it. They're like, yes, yes, yes. They know I'm going to be there often and painting, and so me and the birds. Me and the birds are having a happy with it, so far so good, and I'll try to settle down, and I'll try not to make too much noise so the neighbors don't hear me singing or anything out there, and because that would be what do you call it, one of those events. The woman is singing in the back garden, and I can hear her in my back garden, so I have to be really quiet, and but the day is unfolded to make such a construction, so it's kind of fun. It's kind of fun to actually finish it. It's kind of standard, just a standard rectangle, and I'm slightly upset that I went with standard rectangle, but I could not figure out anything else at the moment. In a hurry, I could have connected all the bamboos and made some elaborate rooftop. I've done this in the past, and I had the rope to do it, but I don't know. I was just in a hurry. Just finish it before it may rain, you know, it may rain. And I had to throw away my teddy bear today, a little tiny teddy bear. I had to throw him away because of, I don't know, rat issues. I had too many rat acquaintances living on his fur. I couldn't wash them out. So... that was terrible to now throw the teddy bear into the garbage. But anyway, that's the life. So now I have an artist studio, and I have this reminiscent moment of the past. Here it is, my watercolors. Oh, Snoopa. Snoopa, sorry about this one. Yeah, my watercolors and this other idea. With making the bubbles in the material, just in case you're bored and you have no other way of making possible. And then I'm like, well, what is this? You know, we have all of these ways of making art, and yet does it make money? Does any of it make money? You know what I'm saying? A bit scary. Does it make money? I don't care. I just don't care. Don't care. Oh.